everybody's just so excited because we have the world's heavyweight champions here. And I want you to know that I tried to find Jack and Jerry Briscoe, and I went over and tried to find in Oklahoma where they live and some tobacco chewers. I looked at a teepee and I found a cheap bottle of wine there that the Briscoes have been drinking. And I said to myself, with great heavyweight champions like this, and I'm looking at this teepee and it's got Briscoes over top of it, a real classy place, I'm saying to myself, how can the Briscoes possibly have beaten the world's heavyweight champions right on national television in front of everybody? It don't make no sense to me.
They didn't beat us. We were sick. We had the flu the last time we were here, the last time we wrestled the Briscoes. The doctors even told us not to show up, right, Adrian? The doctors told us and advised us not to wrestle.
I thought there was something. There was a double pneumonia because they had both of you in the ring at the same time.
I had the Taiwan flu. I was sick to death. 104 fever. I got out of bed to show what I'm made of.
There you go. You see, I knew that there was something wrong, especially when I looked. I know the Briscoes are former world's heavyweight champions. I know all that stuff. But with people like the Briscoes, they're coming up and they're saying they deserve a title shot at you now.
Well, you know, it seems that Jack and Jerry Briscoe, the last of the Akawis, think they're big stuff. Cry to the promoters, do they? They want a title shot? There's other teams in line, Daddy. Isn't that right, Dick? Frankie Williams?
Yes.
Rivera.
Yes, there's lots of teams in line.
That's right. You know, Roddy, we are definitely back. We're definitely healthy now. We're back in shape and line up.
You figure the Briscoes are in shape? Just a little cheap wine. These are the plum of the people that you people. Oh,
could I hold it? Could I hold it?
These are real champions, and these are what champions are made of, not the Briscoes.